Atrial fibrillation, or AF, is a very common condition and the most common cause of an irregular heartbeat, although many people with the condition don't know they have it. But what exactly is AF, and why is it important to diagnose and treat? First, let's take a closer look at how the heart works. The heart is made up of two upper chambers, called atria, and two lower chambers, called ventricles. During a regular cycle of the heartbeat, the atria contract first, pushing blood into the ventricles, and then the ventricles contract, pumping blood around the body. This happens in a very regular, steady rhythm controlled by the heart's natural pacemaker, which means that blood is pumped in an efficient and effective way. In atrial fibrillation, the electrical signals that control the regular rhythm of the heartbeat become disturbed. The upper chambers quiver, or fibrillate, in an irregular way, which then causes the lower chambers to beat erratically, causing an irregular and often abnormally fast heartbeat. As a result, the heart doesn't fill properly in between contractions, reducing its pumping efficiency. AF may come and go in episodes, or last for long periods at a time, or may even be present all the time. The cause of AF is not fully understood, but it tends to affect certain groups of people, such as older people, and those with long-term conditions, such as high blood pressure, heart conditions, or lung conditions. However, in many cases, an underlying cause is not found. In many cases, AF causes no symptoms, and so it is instead picked up during a pulse check or routine tests. However, it can cause symptoms as well, such as heart palpitations, where your heart briefly feels like it's pounding, fluttering, or beating irregularly, tiredness, dizziness, breathlessness, feeling faint or lightheaded, chest pain, either at rest or during physical activity, and finding it harder to exercise. Despite often causing few symptoms, AF is a serious condition because of the severe and life-threatening complications it can cause, such as a stroke. This is because it increases the risk of clots forming in the heart, which can then go on to block the blood supply to the brain, causing a stroke. AF also increases the risk of heart failure, where the heart is unable to pump blood around the body effectively. Therefore, it is very important that it is picked up early. Atrial fibrillation is often first suspected if you have an irregular pulse. A doctor will confirm the diagnosis with an ECG or EKG, which stands for electrocardiogram. In this test, stickers called electrodes are placed on the chest, which measure the electrical activity in the heart. It is painless and only takes a few minutes. Sometimes a doctor may recommend wearing a portable ECG recorder to monitor the heart trace continuously over a period of time to help catch an episode of AF. If it is diagnosed, other tests may also be performed to look for an underlying cause, such as blood tests or ultrasound imaging of the heart, called an echocardiogram or echo. The main aims of treatment are to reduce the risk of complications, such as stroke or heart failure, and control any symptoms. Individual treatment plans will vary based on factors like age, overall health, and the risk of complications. If an underlying cause is found, for example, thyroid problems, this will be treated. Treatments may include anticoagulants, which thin the blood and prevents clotting, medications to control a fast heart rate, cardioversion to control the heart rhythm, which can either be through a controlled electric shock procedure or by medication. Ablation is another option, where diseased areas of the heart that might be interrupting normal electrical circuits are carefully destroyed. Both cardioversion and ablation have a mixed chance of success and are often not permanent. Finally, there is the option of inserting a pacemaker, a small, battery-operated device implanted in the chest that restores a regular heart rhythm. Lifestyle changes are an important complement to therapy and can help keep your heart healthy, such as stopping smoking, eating healthily and managing weight, increasing physical activity, controlling blood pressure and cholesterol, reducing alcohol intake. So, while AF affects people differently, with some having few symptoms, it is always an important condition to diagnose and treat. AF is generally a manageable condition, and with the right treatment, people with AF can reduce their risk of complications to lead normal and healthy lives. We hope this Health Sketch has been useful for you and those around you. Health Sketch. Health for all to see.